Data has changed the face of our world over the last decades, and people now generate nearly 2.5 quintillion bytes of data daily around the globe. Businesses, both large and small, deal with massive data volumes, and much depends on their ability to gather meaningful insights from them. Data analysts do precisely that. The team and I analyze our data in order to find ways to improve our portfolio management processes, make them more profitable and more efficient. We collect huge amounts of data every day, and by analyzing what has happened in the past, we can make strong predictions about what will happen in the future. Therefore, me and my colleagues from other EOS countries are increasingly employing AI and modeling within the whole EOS group. We are all connected through the Hamburg-based Center of Analytics, where know-how on models and AI is being shared. In Belgium, we have modeled historical payment plans and analyzed which plans were the most successful. Using a set of variables called features, we can now match an existing debtor to a similar historical case. Then the model creates a suggestion for which plan has the highest likelihood to be paid. After analyzing the data, we talk to those experts who were responsible for the topic and find out which variable they used when they had the same target, together with some common features. In principle, we then translate their real-world experience into code. What follows is the 80-20 testing. Let's say that you have a dataset of 10,000 historical cases. We use 8,000 of these cases to develop our model and achieve the best performance we can get. Next, we take the remaining 2,000 unseen data and apply the model on these. Hopefully, at this stage, the model's outcome reflects what happens in real life. If not, we can still fine-tune the model by applying different features, different variables, and different algorithms until the model reflects what happens really in real life. A second test is when the model is in production. We perform A/B testing with two homogeneous groups of data, where we apply the old process versus the model. You then compare the performance of these two groups based on different KPIs. So overall, you see that it's really an iterative process that we optimize until we reach the optimal performance. In the end, the goal is to change finances for the better. In the example of modeling of payment plans, there are several benefits. Defaulting payer benefits because the plan is more customized to their situation. EOS and our clients also benefit as we only use, of course, models that via our testing generate a higher success rate.